as we formed this organization and elected offices, and I remember you were the secretary.
Yeah.
And that's probably why you kept so many wonderful minutes of this group made yourself the personal historian.
Yeah. We always thought about the future and other kids who needed help. That was always at the forefront of this organization when we organized the Autism Society in North Carolina. And we knew that services was what was needed, and some way or another we had to get them just like other disability groups had.
Some of the most important things that happened while I was there as president and then as executive director were setting up an office, getting a big mailing list, setting up the group home for high-functioning people who could be competitively employed, and then going on to set up a number of other group homes, enlarging TEACH in the sense of having more TEACH centers, and beginning the Living and Learning Center.
One of the things that I do believe is unique about the relationship of the Autism Society in North Carolina and its professionals is that TEACH and the Autism Society grew up together. They were working together very collaboratively right from the get-go. And that was, in a sense, an outgrowth of the philosophy of TEACH, which was parents as partners that Eric Schaupler and Bob Regler started. And just over the years, the two organizations just kind of fed off each other and supported each other and worked together on every important piece of legislation or every important act.
I think the most important thing that the Autism Society has done, going back to whenever I was chairman of the board, was to see that services were going to be provided educationally for the children of this state with autism and their families.
Really, the Autism Society is not a building. It's not some professionals that they are working here, you know, 12 hours a day or less or more, but they are caring people.
One very important point about the Autism Society of North Carolina for my parents and for myself has been the provision of affordable or free services, not just to myself, but to all persons on the autism spectrum at all ages.
It was time to begin to provide some kinds of services for their children, and camp was a natural. And under Boba Warren's leadership, they made it happen.
We have established a camp that is a model in the nation. I'm not sure that it's been replicated anywhere else, but I think the important work that was done there was to give children a place to go for at least a week in the summer.
Camp Royal was the culmination of years of very important and productive relationship between the Autism Society and the legislature, and in particular Senator Kenneth Royal, who had a very special interest in autism and was determined to help the society achieve its goal of having its own permanent campsite. So the legislature funded the building of the campsite. The Autism Society quickly was able to develop the programming that fit that campsite, so that now hundreds of children and adolescents and adults every year are able to have a recreational experience that is, you know, incomparable.
They were always supportive of us, and I don't think that the camp that we're sitting in today would even be here if Eric and Bob had not gone along with us on that first milestone, which was to see if it was possible for children to have an overnight experience away from home.
After the establishment of the camp, which pretty much dominated the work of the Autism Society in the early years, the society grew, hired an executive director and other professionals, and the programs they run now are excellent ones. They have an excellent bookstore, they've run a very strong CAP program that families really like. They've been involved in residential and vocational services, and they are involved with important activities with the legislature. They run a excellent conference every year, just many, many accomplishments.
I know people from all over the world and all over the United States of America that they have moved to North Carolina for the great services that we have for people with autism. And the Autism Society is the reason that those services are in place.
Another important thing was working through the society to the National Society, where I became vice president and then government affairs chairperson, working with Congress to get autism into the congressional record as eligible for support services.
With the explosion of diagnosis to 1 in 100 more or less, that just creates more challenges for the Autism Society as well as TEACH and other agencies, because there's so many families with so many children and adolescents and adults of so many stripes, I guess you could say, so many variations on the theme, that it really poses a tremendous challenge of where to direct energy, where to put money, how to provide the support services that are needed. I think the Autism Society is up to the challenge, but the starting point is recognizing that this is a challenge, that the playing field has changed.
I think the Autism Society has a characteristic that is welcoming everyone, and in a world that you don't feel alone if you have a son with autism.
I have been able to live an independent life, a successful independent life on the autism spectrum because of many of the adult services and programs that the Autism Society has made available to myself and my family.
I guess the Autism Society needs should continue doing what it's already doing, offering autistic summer camp and having its annual conference with which has ideas related to it, and keep in touch with people in general concerning autism.
In the future for the Autism Society, we have many challenges ahead, but we also have many opportunities to deliver services and programming for everyone on the autism spectrum in this state.
The Autism Society has been working so hard for 40 years and never asked anyone of us help us. But I can see the Autism Society said, we are here to help you. And it's a call for every one of us in order to contribute in any way for the work in the next 40 years.
if I'd be a little bit smarter than I am. Bigger and stronger too, baby. But none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend.